In the beginning, the world was subjugated by chaos. Then, the Keepers came to be torchbearer, shaper, and judge. The three fought the spawn of chaos, and ultimately, they prevailed. Chaos could be banished, but it could not be destroyed. So the Keepers weaved a veil with their own essence and stood guard. The world was now safe, but it was also empty and meaningless. Thus, the Keepers reached beyond the veil. They seized the power of chaos itself. They gave it shape and purpose. They created life, and man was their most perfect creation. But all life would eventually hear the call from beyond the veil. Thus it happened that, alongside life, death also came to the world. The great cycle was set in motion. Yet chaos hungered for more and sought to undo the Keeper's creation. The spawn of chaos struck, wounding the Keepers and tearing the veil. Endless droves of horrors trespassed into the world. And so came the Soulstice of Souls. Hurt and weak, the Keepers charged man with defending the world. They inspired man to fight fire with fire, ferocity with ferocity. Driven by the infinite wisdom of the Keepers, man turned the very power of chaos against it. Through sacrifice and resolve, a breed of sacred warriors was created. Three were wounds in the essence of the Keepers. Three the mighty battles fought and won by the champions of man. Three the sacred cities that were built in those hallowed places. Eventually, the Soulstice of Souls was put to an end. The three cities still stand to this day for the glory of the Keepers, while the memory of the sacred warriors has been lost to time. But while the mortal body must perish, that which is immortal is bound to be reborn.
Too enthusiastic. Someone here is more than eager to welcome us.
It began here somehow. What could unleash such immense power?
If we survive, we might find some answers. Now let's focus on destroying these things.
Strong aura
and more.
Just won't give up.
I'd be disappointed if it did. Now it's our turn.
Set a small tear. Not that the world's veil ripped apart. Look, there, above the cathedral.
Ilden. One of the three capitals. The seat of the Torchbearer.
Once the light of the kingdom. Now it burns.
I can't do this. Why the Otis and us deal with the other chimeras? I'm not ready. We are not ready.
To them, we are just Briar and Loot. The outcasts. I say this is our chance to prove ourselves. We can't waste it. Anyway, we're late. Can you sense the others?
The echo of the dead is just too strong. It dulls my senses.
Loot, you need to focus.
Forgive me. I will do better. Whatever ripped open the veil must be powerful.
Let's look for our observer.
He should be able to tell us more of what transpired here.
Then we best find him quickly. I know all too well how chaos corrupts and kills.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean...
We have more important tasks than mourning those we can't save.
We were saved. Do not forget. Miles along the bay. They once teemed with life. And now?
It's like this city has been dead for years. Ilden is no more loot. We better get used to the idea.
By the waves here. It reminds me of home. We are not. These broke. They were just people once before they became corrupted.
Call this the judge's mercy, then. one down.
Let's keep it up.
To us like moths to a flame.
They can't resist the lure of life. Even though it comes from us.
Observer, the sooner we get to him, the better.
Life must perish. That which is immortal is bound to be reborn. But the Shaper had no hand in your creation. Did he, sweet sisters?
You're our observer?
I am Layton. I am here to assist you.
How exactly? An observer's talents won't be of much help in this fight.
Oh, I fight for the Order of the Ashen Blade, in my own way. My presence here is proof enough of my worth. You, on the other hand, are said to be unstable, unruly, and unwilling to follow orders.
Our fame precedes us.
Why do you taunt us?
Your shade is speaking. And to me, how quaint.
Somehow, your authority as an observer is not enough to silence her. What happened here?
A tear opened, clearly. Its cause is unknown. But it's the largest yet seen, and I do believe, getting larger still.
I doubt the Order will be able to hide this one from the masses.
And once it was open?
Many were corrupted, others were possessed. They saw to the rest.
The Order did not foresee it this time.
That is why you were called. You and your two comrades.
Three chimeras. At least the Ashen Blade is sparing no effort now.
Well, two chimeras. And you.
So caustic. Where are the others?
Strangely, those two did not wish to wait for you. You should hurry. Find them and help them. If you can. Don't scowl at me. I can offer powerful assistance if you do well.
Then let us pray you remain safe.
Indeed. May the Torchbearer light your way.
May the Judge show you mercy.
And may the Shaper grant you fortune in this life. If that's what you can call it. The freight elevators will take you where you need to go.
Good.
Perhaps you will prove us all wrong. I will be watching.
You make fun of us, but what do you even know about our kind?
That the Order forges the chimeras, much like your big sword. Let us hope you're not brittle or blunt.
We're not weapons. We're people.
I find that argument quite hard to sustain in your current predicament. Anyway, each chimera is born of a union of two different souls. And each one develops their own abilities in a most peculiar way. I am truly eager to find out what the two of you can do.
This is your first time with us as our observer.
Indeed. I must have committed some horrible sin to deserve it. Oh, don't be so touchy. You'd better get used to my witty remarks anyway. Just as I'll have to accept that I'm stuck here with you.
To everyone their penance.
So we have the grumpy, the witty, and the wise. A well-assorted team indeed. I'm sure we'll get along just fine.
If you say so. We've dealt with other tears before, but none as massive as this.
Definitely not the doing of a few rampaging wraiths.
They're always ripping and gnawing at the veil from the other side. Relentlessly.
Indeed. Something else must have happened here. We must find out what it was.
Layton, tell us the truth. How can you survive the dangers of this city?
Oh, I rely on my cunning first and foremost, but I also have this pendant. It emits a sound that hides my aura from those that would prey upon it.
I can hear your jingling as well, in spite of my corrupted blood.
I am so glad to hear it. It means that I have nothing to fear from the two of you. For the time being, at least. You know how to find me.
Think too much, Luke.
Now it's my turn.
You want more? I've got more.
Freight elevators. Someone blocked them.
But that would stop the people escaping.
Exactly. They left on their precious ships and left the rest to die. That way, they'd made sure they'd escape.
So cruel. Letting others die so they could live.
And yet they all died anyway.
This way to the bridge.
If it works. Yes, despite my weakness.
That power was immense. It's not your fault.
Then whose fault is it? You saw. I almost. If I gave in to the corruption inside me, you'd be lost. I won't allow it.
You resisted. No other chimera could have done that.
No other chimera with a damn corrupted as a knight, you mean?
Sister, that was an insanely powerful aura. And there's something else. I could sense there were two chimeras at the source. I felt their strain, their suffering. They pushed themselves to their limits. It was like a scream in my head. But then all of a sudden, they were gone.
Both of them. Are you certain?
I can't sense either of them now. And the other aura is gone too.
Not for good, I'd wager.
We might be the only ones left to fight it.
Be on guard, then. We may have to deal with that sooner or later. Thank you.
ethereal resident from the tear. It bears the taint of the corruption. We can shatter them if we work together. Let me focus my energy.
Matter who they were.
It mattered. The guards sealed the gates,
trapping the people inside.
They tried to contain the corrupted and failed.
Sister, a powerful aura was here. It left traces, like
Like an echo.
What was it?
I can't tell, but those traces may just let us see what happened.
Never seen the knights acting like this before.
Me neither. Whatever's in there must be really valuable.
You try to steal it then. I'm staying here. Whatever it is, it feels like the judge's breath on my neck.
Shut up, they'll hear you.
Soldiers, the next one of you who speaks will be flogged. The one after that will be hung. The one after that, courted. Have I made myself clear? Good.
Soldiers of the Order? They were afraid.
Yes, but not of the knights, regardless of their threats.
Easy now, easy. Not my choice to come this way, is it? I like it no more than you do. Settle down.
Even the animals were restless.
They could sense the danger too. This echo is so vivid. The dead are screaming all around us. But this cuts through it all. It left a deep scar on the ether. That scares me the most.
Halt! In the name of the Triarchy and the Shining City of Ilden! The Ashen Blade. What is your business here?
We carry a gift. From the Grand Master of the Order to the High Clergy of Ilden.
Is that all?
We are expected at the Cathedral of Guiding Light.
We had no advance notice of your arrival. You can't just show up and...
Our papers speak for themselves. Here. Now let us in, if you care for your useless job. And your worthless life.
Just let them in! It's not worth dying for!
Fine. Good, sir. Of course. You may pass. May the Torchbearer light your way.
Well, this is the City of Light, is it not?
Now I understand. The aura I feel, the one that left this echo. It came from inside that armored carriage.
Can you tell me what was inside?
I can't see inside. The carriage is lined with something. It's dulling my perception, so this was done on purpose. By someone who knows the Order, who knows its secrets.
You mean... us? The Chimeras?
I think so. That carriage is at the heart of whatever happened here.
Then we have to find it.
And soon. Whatever it's doing here might not be finished.